Hey everybody, it's Ginger on Wheels here again. Thanks for stopping by the channel where we get to test and unbox the latest electrically wheeled gadgets. You've been watching me ride around on the VSET 9 Plus scooter, which is an amazing scooter by the way, but today we have a very similar scooter. This is called the Varla Pegasus. It's also got two 500 watt motors and it has a 15.6 amp hour battery. It has solid tires though, so it's a little bit different than the 9 Plus, but I'm excited to get it out of the box and do some side-by-side testing of these scooters. So let's roll the intro and go ahead and open the box. All right, here it is. We're gonna do things a little differently today. This is gonna be a POV unboxing. We got the official GOW box cutter. Just gonna go ahead and cut the zip ties right here. All right, go ahead and slice the tape. It has big staples holding the box in. This is a little bit different. I only saw this on the WePed. Never seen that on another scooter box. Very sharp though, be careful. All right. Looks like the box got a little munched here on this stem. Okay. One piece of foam, two pieces of foam. Ooh, this is a really thick stem. The metal feels thin, but the actual diameter is really thick. So for this stem design, there's two bolts in the top, or two little screws. I'm guessing you just remove those two screws, place the bar inside the handles, or in that little hole here, and then put this piece back on the top. So let's go ahead and do that now. Looks like the screw on the handlebar is a size 4. So I just place the bars in that little groove in the top there, and I'm gonna put this piece back on. I push the screen all the way forward, but I have the bars where I want them in the hole, and then I'm just gonna put this piece back on the top. Okay, so then I'm just gonna move the screen back up so I can see it while I'm riding, and then tighten these two screws right here, which are look like the size 3s. They're already pretty tight. Interesting. So you can see here, the plastic is touching. This can't actually tighten anymore without cracking the plastic, but the screen still wiggles a little bit. There's a little piece of rubber right here that's supposed to act as a buffer, but it doesn't look like it's thick enough to actually hold that on. That's interesting. Nice little thumb throttle here, that's surprising. Comfortable grips too. They have like a textured pattern on the back here and little finger slots in the front. Let's go ahead and actually lift the thing out of the box. Sort of got distracted with the handlebars there. So this scooter, I believe it weighs 66 pounds, and I think that's the same as the VSET. So I don't know how easy this will be for you to see, but there's one little pin that holds the whole latch closed. There's this red safety button. You have to push the button, and then you can undo the clasp. But, I don't know, how much do I trust that? Is what it is. Let's go ahead and tighten that. Well, it's pretty tight. I won't tighten that right now. Wow. This scooter might be defective. I don't know. Maybe it just needs to be broken in. These bars are really hard to turn. There's some cables coming out of the stem here, and one of them has the green connector on the end, and it looks like it just plugs into the throttle right there. I'll connect those. Boop. I'm like 10 minutes into owning this thing and I'm already taking it apart, but I used a size 6 Allen wrench to loosen a screw over here, and then there's another screw back there that hold on this black collar piece. And then I took a size 10 and unscrewed this bolt, took it out. I'm trying to look for a way to adjust the steering bearing, but it doesn't appear there's actually a way I can do that. So it's just gonna be really tight as I ride. If you ever have a problem on this scooter where the bars are turning like left and right, but the wheel is staying in the same spot, then that means you need to tighten this black bolt in the top here. I'm gonna get the bars lined up and then put this piece back in. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at this scooter now that we got it out of the box. This is a grip here, brake lever. Looks like cable actuated disc brakes. We get an up and a down button. This is probably for our gears. And then there's an M button here for mode, I would assume. Nice little analog bell. Can't go wrong with those. On this side of the scooter, this is our thumb throttle, which is surprising. I didn't know the scooter had a thumb throttle, but it feels pretty easy to manage. So I'm excited to ride around on this thing with the thumb throttle. This looks like our front brake here. So let's go ahead and see if I can figure out how to turn it on. I'm gonna hold the M button, see what happens. Oh, what do you know? Screen turned right on. Cool, okay, wow. That's a lot of energy bars. Nice little accurate, seems pretty accurate, battery gauge. This is really bright too. I'm gonna push the up button and see if it goes into speed two. Yep, PAS2. That stands for pedal assist, which that means this is an e-bike controller or a throttle on here, because obviously we're in a scooter, we don't have pedals. Okay, just gonna do some quick measurements here for all you folks curious at home. The handlebar grips look like 4.5 inches long. The brake lever is 4 inches long-ish. The screen size, 2 inches by, looks like 3.25. And obviously just the same grip on the other side. Let's measure the deck to bar height. Yeah, this one's actually the full 40 inches. Impressive. I like that scooter manufacturers are realizing that not everyone is 5 feet tall and some scooters need taller bars. So these are our solid tires. Yep, those are solid. Interesting. The fender doesn't look quite long enough, but I like how wide it is. These are 3.5 inch wide tires. You can see we got the swing arm suspension here and the coil for the suspension is inside here. Here's our charging port right here. And this scooter comes with a 2-amp charger, so we can charge it up in 8 hours. Okay, so inside the bottom of the box here, there was this other little box. Let's open this up and see what's inside of here. Okay, inside of here, we have the charger. This is our multi-tool, whole bunch of accessories. Oh, it comes with a lock, that's cool. It comes with like a really heavy, thick chain lock. Didn't see that coming. I don't even have one of these yet. This is a cool little accessory to get. I'm sure that you could snip through it with bolt cutters, but hey, unless someone's walking around with bolt cutters, they're not getting your scooter. Cool. That's they give you a little picture so you know what the Velcro's for. Well, that's good, because I didn't know. We have an extra one of those little hook bolt things that goes in the rear of the deck, a couple of brake pads, and 2 screws. Nice glossy pages. Oh, it gives you all the dimensions for the scooter right here. I guess I don't need to waste time doing that. It's got scooter parts. Tells you how to screw in the handlebars in case you missed me doing it. Yep, tells you to connect the throttle controller just like we did. So this is the folding mechanism, and they tell you if your folding mechanism is loose, tighten this screw inside here. So that's a good tip. This goes ahead to tell us all the different indicators on the throttle. I'm curious how to turn the lights on though, so let's see if it says in here. Headlight. Long press the up button for 2 seconds to turn on and off the headlight. Here, in speed 1, the top speed is 10 miles an hour. In speed 2, top speed is 16 miles an hour. And in speed 3, top speed is 28 miles per hour. Well, let's go ahead and test our lights. So I'm gonna hold the M button for 3 seconds to turn the scooter on. That turns the display on. And then I'm gonna hold the up button for 2 seconds. And oh yeah, we got a headlight. Look at that. So just a pretty simple plug and play 12 volt headlight, nothing special here. Looks like the same one that's on the eMove Cruiser actually. Just tighten it down to adjust it where you want it, but it's not that bright. I would recommend a bar-mounted headlight for the scooter, because I can tell you from experience, that's not gonna be enough. The kickstand, in case I didn't mention before, it's actually in the front, right there. Oh, the deck body is plastic. This whole body is plastic, it feels like. Okay, now the moment of truth here. I'm gonna go ahead and jump on it and see what the suspension is like. Okay. It's not quite as cushiony as the Varla, but it does have more give than something like the Titan Pro does. Or even the Mantis SE. Not a lot of travel though. You know, maybe 1.5 or 2 inches. So these tires online say that they're 3.5 inches wide. But I can tell you they're 3 inches wide. So it looks like the usable deck space here is gonna be about 20 inches, and then you get this little platform that's raised to put your foot on. And there's no grip tape. It's just this textured plastic mat that has little diamonds in it. Feels really similar to the compound for the tires and the handlebars. So this will be slippery when wet, but when it's dry, it should be okay. But I don't think you're supposed to ride this scooter in the wet anyway. It does have an IP water resistant rating, but that's just for like light splashes through puddles and things like that. Okay, let's put our little Velcro strap exactly where the manual said to put it, which is right above the safety release. Yeah, make sure that's properly fitted in there before you go riding, because this is what's gonna keep the water out of your stem tube. Let's adjust this. This is meant to go right above the red clasp here.
So I've got it just like that. To be honest, not the safest design, but it's better than nothing.
So I am 6'1.5" tall. Let me give you a good idea of what the scooter looks like when I'm standing on it. I'm gonna fall into my Dualtrons. Yeah, nice bar height. The steering is still really stiff. It is looser than when I first took it out of the box. I wonder if it's just gonna loosen over time, but still very, very stiff. It like doesn't turn easily. Oh, that's cool. The kickstand on the very bottom has a little hook so that you don't have to bend over and deploy it. It'll just go with your shoe. I found out what the little clamp on the deck is for in the back. It's actually to fold the scooter. So you just put the bars down and then that little hook goes right in this hole here. And then you can carry the scooter around while it's folded. In case you're wondering, these are just stickers. They're not actual like lights or reflectors or anything. They do look semi-reflective, but just stickers. All right, you guys, that's gonna conclude this unboxing. It was pretty straightforward, no surprises really, other than the stiff steering. But I like the fact that I have a 2-amp charger because now I can just chuck it on the charger overnight and we'll get to do the range test tomorrow. So stay tuned for that video. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time.